dystopian times.
So, folks, this week I have a new content creator that I discovered that took my recommendation that leftists should occasionally touch grass to heart. And he films all of his videos outdoors. So, folks, this is our featured content creator of the week.
Hey, everybody. So my name's Eric, and my channel is called Left Alone Talking, which I'm pretty proud to have thought of because I think it works on a few different levels. Look at that. Bam. Dragonfly on my thumb. First is, I'm in nature. Dragonflies fly on my thumb. I've been left alone to talk, and so that's pretty undeniable. The second is that I do fancy myself as somebody who's on the left politically, but then I listen to other media outlets and pundits, and what they tell me is that he's on the left, and that she's on the left, and that he's on the left, and that she's on the left, and these are people that I do not agree with, by and large, and I don't respect, and I certainly wouldn't want to be grouped into the same ideological framework as them, as the left. And so if I'm not on the left like them, that would either leave me to be on the right, which I'm certainly not, a centrist, which I just think would be embarrassing. And so I guess that just means that I'm on the left, but I've been left alone. And so then I talk about it, and that's what this channel is. So a little bit about me. I've worked a lot with different liberal institutions, primarily NGOs and nonprofits, mostly doing environmental organizing, but I've also done different mid-level management type things. And I've even worked for the Democratic Party during the general election in swing states for two cycles, but I didn't like it, if that helps anything. And I'm, because I don't like them mostly, but I'm able to rationalize it through kind of Chomskyan lesser evil voting arguments, which I think are valid, as well as a little bit of transparent careerism, which I use to mash down the cognitive dissidence. But I still feel gross afterwards, and I have a yucky taste in my mouth. And so what I do is if you see that, that's a van which I made, which I use to travel the country, and I see America, and America's pretty effed up. In fact, I even just traveled to Akron, Ohio to volunteer for one of the only Democrats I've ever liked, Nina Turner, and we know how that went. And I use all of that as righteous indignation, which I use to fuel the fire of my political YouTube channel. What else do I discuss on my channel? Really anything which I think is important and interesting, but under-discussed or poorly discussed in the mainstream, which unfortunately, in my opinion, is most of the issues, and most of those issues are depressing. And that's not an energy I want to put out there, and so I try to counteract it by doing little jokes here and there, and putting swamps in the background, and stones, and ferns, and spruces, and really anything to take the edge off. And I do quirky fun thumbnails, which the people love, because it's a lot easier to hear about the Obama administration's immediate betrayal of the change that it promised to millions of Americans, which for the first time in their lives actually hoped that things could change, by instead immediately bailing out the banks which funded his campaign and then refusing to prosecute any of the sociopathic executives on Wall Street which crashed the economy on a scale which is unfathomable, in favor of instead prosecuting more whistleblowers than any other president, as well as nonviolent drug offenders out the wazoo and continuing the drug war. That's kind of depressing. But if the president is represented in the thumbnail as a mother mallard slowly escorting its ducklings towards the lake, that makes it great for everyone. And so I encourage you to check out the channel. Please subscribe if you're interested. I also did a 7-part podcast on Obama's memoir, which is I made into a 10-hour YouTube video and then broke into 7-part podcast and clipped into a bunch of videos. If you want to check out that, you can, but thanks for the time.
Well, folks, that was Left Alone Talking. I will put links in the description box. If you're watching this on YouTube, if you're watching on Means TV, you will have to go to YouTube and search for Left Alone Talking. I think we can easily get this person to 1,000 subscribers in the next couple of weeks. So let's make it happen and support independent media. But on that note, on Tuesday, that is the very last day that you could submit your channel to be considered as a featured content creator of the week, because on September 8th, that is the season finale of Dystopian Times. It won't be coming back until next year, possibly the year afterwards. I don't know. So make sure you get in your submission before Tuesday, or by the end of Tuesday, if you want it to be considered. So there's episode 8. So there's 2 slots left. Please make sure that you give yourself the opportunity. Send me an unlisted YouTube video and email it to mike@humanistreport.com with the subject line DT_submissions in all caps. Folks, we've had some phenomenal people featured. We have had Anthony Park of Next Step Productions, Alex Kawa, Spencer Snyder, and the great Good Politic guy who's on today. So, yeah, folks, definitely be sure to submit your channels.